championships and the second winningest coach ever at Syracuse. Ed, this series kind of rejuvenated. Last year, Syracuse won at the Big House, 38-28, and Michigan would like to repay. We're ready to kick. Nate Trout has it teed up at the 35. Cato June, number two, along, is ready to receive. And a high kick. Jones at the five. Jones with a nice return. Up to the 19, maybe at the 20-yard line. So that's where Michigan will start their first offensive series. A 16-yard return. The quarterback for the Wolverines, he wears number 10. Tom Brady, a senior, making his 16th consecutive start. He's guided this team to 2-0. He shared time, as Ed talked about, with Drew Henson.
Really had a nice start to the season. There's a little bit of the controversy with Drew Henson behind him. He shrugged that off. And our conversation said he learned a lot from the Brian Greasy Scott Driesback situation 2 years ago.
Completes 69% of his passes, first and 10, Michigan. And they go on the ground. Anthony Thomas, big hole, and rumbles near the 31-yard line. Knocked out by Quentin Harris. Let's check out the rest of that Michigan offense behind Brady, and he's got some talent. Anthony Thomas at the tailback, Shea, Marcus Knight, Terrell, and Thompson the tight end. Up front, it's a big line. Back is Hutchinson, the All-American. Frazier at center, along with Atkins and Mast.
And you just saw right there, off the left side, Anthony Thomas went over Backus and Hutchinson. Both juniors, they have 52 starts between them, both very good on that left side. We had offsetting penalties to start the game, so.
James McConaughey, tonight's referee. This crew, Ed, consists of four from the Big East and three from the Big Ten.
But you will start to see the Michigan offensive line. They took a challenge this week. They're only averaging 128 yards rushing a game. That's good, not good enough for Michigan, that left side of that line. Watch them all night.
Michigan will spread it out with four wideouts. Anthony Thomas near side, alone back. Brady, four-step drop, throws to Thomas near sideline, reaches out near the first down marker at the 38. Ian McIntosh made the tackle. Let's check out that orange defense. And for Syracuse, Pettijohn, very, very fast at the left end. Simpkins, Downing, and Dinkins. Linebackers, a very good threesome. Greenwood, Bullock, and Banks. The defensive backs include Allen, McIntosh, Harris, and the track man, David Byrd.
The orange men have Bullock back.
Three plays, three times that Anthony Thomas, Eddie, has carried the football short of the first down, knocked down by Vernon Banks.
Keith Bullock was in on the tackle as well. Bullock sat out last week's game against Central Michigan, a suspension. He got into some drunk driving trouble back in February. The school decided to sit him down. Luckily for him, against Central Michigan, not against Michigan. But Bullock, the heart and soul of this defense, when we were talking to Chris Ripon, the new defensive coordinator, he said, we really missed Bullock. But it was interesting, Craig, when we talked to him, he said he learned a lot about football when he sat out last week. He got to look from the outside in, became more mature.
First down, Michigan, just over the 40-yard line. So two back-to-back first downs, and it's been all Anthony Thomas, the big 6'2", 225-pound junior, averaging 112.5 yards a game.
And Mike DeBoard, the offensive coordinator for Michigan, comes out with a wrinkle the play before. Anthony Thomas was out as a wide receiver.
They double up the far side on first down. Brady, good protection, swings it out to the flat. Again, it's Thomas, and the big man rumbles out of bounds at the 47-yard line.
You're going to see about a 15-yard face mask penalty. Morlon Greenwood over there on the tackle got up around high on Anthony Thomas, and it looked like he brought him down by the face mask.
Well, Ed, Morlon Greenwood, he was a state wrestling champ back in high school at the 215-pound level, so I guess he was putting a one of those holes.
Yeah, but as a wrestler, Craig, you're supposed to shoot a single leg, not go for the head. Now, these are the things you don't need at home against a team like Michigan. you can already hear the crowd start to quiet down because Michigan moving the ball. This was a very good offensive play. Greenwood in good position, but it goes high. There's no way you're going to tackle Anthony Thomas high consistently. Paul Pasqualoni knows he's an ex-linebacker himself. You got to go low on a guy who's that strong.
Terrell and Walker line up near side, fifth play of the drive, and for the fifth time,
and there it is.
It's Anthony Thomas.
And that's how you tackle Anthony Thomas. There's Keith Bullock, the middle linebacker, the leader of this defense. Had 26 consecutive starts before he was suspended last week, but this time goes nice and low. Anthony Thomas is too powerful of a back to hit him up high. You got to take his legs out from underneath him.
Last week against Rice, Anthony Thomas with 21 carries and 87 yards, a couple of touchdowns. He is, as you can tell here on this opening drive, the offensive workhorse for Michigan. Second down and 8. Play action this time. Brady. Good protection, goes to the far sideline, and it's incomplete down inside the 25-yard line. The intended receiver is a Syracuse product, Marquise Walker. And oh, how did Syracuse want this young man to come and put on the orange?
But give all the credit to the Michigan offensive line. Marquise Walker ran a drag route all the way across the field. Tom Brady had all day to stand in there and watch him go across. He checked his first option, his second. Marquise Walker was the third, going all the way across the field. Great job up front by Michigan.
Third down and 8. 3 wide receivers set. As you look at Tom Brady, he'll stand in the shotgun. Knight is the motion man. Brady steps out of the pocket, looks, fires down the middle, throws into coverage, and incomplete.
I would say that was coverage, Craig.
Willie Ford, number 15, one of 3 Orangemen.
Pocket, sets his feet nice, but a bad throw, and at the very end there, number 98, Ricky Simpkins, gets a hold of that ankle. Doesn't look like Brady's hurt, but that was not a good throw by Tom Brady. There were 3 guys from Syracuse back there on coverage.
53-yard attempt. Henson will hold. Epstein will kick. And now whistles on the field.
Got a timeout, Syracuse. Some confusion on who should be in. Spotwood was back deep.
So Syracuse calls timeout. We'll be back with the field goal attempt. A 53-yard attempt. Good snap. Hold is down. Syracuse football at the 44.
It looks to be number 90, Eric Downing, in the middle. Longer kicks. Typically, the kickers have a tendency to really drive the ball, not get enough air underneath of it, and that's the case here. Good push in the middle. The ball blocked immediately. Not tipped, driven right back into Epstein. Just didn't get enough air under that ball. Great push in the middle. Great push in the middle by Syracuse. It did look like number 90, Downing, who got it. Pasqualoni, known for his special teams, has a special teams coordinator, one of the only Division I schools that has that, is Paul Pasqualoni in Syracuse.
And over the years, it has paid off time and time again. First and 10, Syracuse, their first offensive set of the night. And flags are down.
Well, you don't want to start with a delay of game. I know it's a quick turnaround, but once you get your guys, you know what's happening. You got to get them on, call the play on the sideline, and get them out there to run it.
Had a great talk with Coach Pasqualoni yesterday, as we did with Lloyd Carr. Both very intense coaches. They know the importance of this game. The quarterback tonight, redshirt freshman Troy Nunes. 6'1", 182. And you look at his numbers last
shoulder square, we may have finally found that with Troy Nunes. I don't think he was complaining, however, about McNabb.
No, no. From the shotgun, Sedano and D. Brown join him in the backfield. On first and 15, this one goes out to Spotwood. Williams, Renas, and Wilson up front. Renas, the fifth-year senior. Brooks, Gold, Jones, and Hall are your four linebackers, and the defensive backs include Whitley, Hendricks, Patman, and Todd Howard.
So much depth for Michigan at the linebacker spot. They have about nine guys who you'll see lined up at linebacker.
From the eye, Mungrove goes in motion, third down. Nunes, again, the patience, the quick feet. To the 34-yard line, first down, Orange. Ian Gold able to chase him down.
Here's what you got to look at if you want to be a quarterback. Watch how he stays square to the line of scrimmage. Still looks downfield. The pocket begins to collapse. Keeps the left hand on the ball. Nothing there. Now I tuck it. Very good job by Nunes of tucking that ball up under and shows some of those quicks. A lot of people thought he was going to be more of a pocket type passer, and he is, but he does have the athletic ability. A lot of Division I schools recruited him as just an athlete, not as a quarterback, but that's why he ended up at Syracuse.
First down, Syracuse from the Michigan 34-yard line. Mungrove, maybe a couple to the 33. Mungrove, a superb high school athlete back in Pennsylvania. Boy, you talk about his numbers, over 8,400 yards rushing.
It was great when we were talking to Pasqualoni yesterday. He said, here's a guy, came in from high school, never had to block for anybody. So we got here, he said, you mean I got to block? I got to pick up blitzing linebackers? So Pasqualoni told him, look, do all the other things, then we'll let you carry the ball. And he's getting a lot better at that.
Three wideouts to the far side. D. Brown in motion. Second down and nine. Blitz. Noon stumbles and falls back at the 43. And Grady Brooks opened up the door. Boy, he came running through.
Well, young quarterback, the one thing Michigan said they were going to do is blitz him so that he has to make reads. Grady Brooks is unblocked coming from the outside because Syracuse emptied the backfield. We saw D. Brown come out to the left side. That time Brooks unblocked, comes in, gets his first sack of the season. But Nunes has to be able to read that, and him and the receiver on the side of the blitz have to do what's called sight adjust, meaning that the receiver changes his route when he sees that blitz coming.
Brooks, only a junior out of Dallas, Texas. Third down, 19. Syracuse going with a shotgun. This time to the hands of Nunes. He's in trouble. Back to deck, and Nunes covers up. Back to the 35-yard line.
Corey Bowens is the center. It looked like a good snap, just went through the hands of Nunes. A lot of heat on that snap, but it did hit Nunes right in the hand. As a former center myself, shotgun snap's one of the hardest things to do when you know the other team is bringing heat. You try to get it back there quick, but that time Bowens put too much heat on the ball, although Nunes should have been able to handle it.
Mike Schaefer back to kick. A good hanger. Down at the 18. 43-yard kick, and Knight loses four, and we'll step aside. 9:34 to go, opening quarter here in Syracuse.
Thomas had a great start to his career as a freshman, then kind of went through that injury period. Claims to be 100% healthy now. Looks like he is. But if you saw the Notre Dame game, we had it at the open of the game, his balance is incredible. That run he had to the outside where he put his hand down and got into the end zone, plays low to the ground. He's 6'2", so he's not a short guy at running back, but incredible balance, keeps his legs moving.
And, went on to win that game against Notre Dame. Reverse, coming around the corner is Terrell. He's got speed, finds the seam, breaks it at the 45 to the 44 of Syracuse. Vernon Banks able to knock him out.
Now, if you are David Terrell, you go back to the huddle and you thank Tom Brady. Hands off to Thomas. Brady rolling to the left and gets a cut block right there on Simpkins. That allows Terrell to get around the corner. This is an exciting player. They talk, the name Charles Woodson comes up when they talk about David Terrell. Wants to play some defense. Did against Notre Dame because of a couple injuries, but has that breakaway speed. The Michigan coaches very hesitant, though, because they want him to become more efficient on offense.
They had a 15-yard gain, and you talk about him wanting to be the Deion Sanders of sorts. Charles Woodson.
They like to talk about Charles Woodson.
But he's got the stats to back it up in high school. A tremendous defensive back. Had 30 career picks in high school. Of course, making the jump to Division I is a little bit different, but yet this guy has tremendous speed.
David Byrd was shooken up on the play. He's now coming to the sideline. He's one of the DBs that Syracuse cannot lose. Missed the 97 season. He ran track. Had to earn.
Replaces him, number three, at the right corner. Michigan now with six first downs compared to just one for Syracuse. Brady, nice throw around the money. And he hooks up with Marquise Walker, as I mentioned before, out of Syracuse, New York. Played at Henniger High School. And Ed, they wanted this young man here so bad, Paul Pasqualoni, that they sent the big guy over to his house to talk. 5 yards. Ninth play of this drive. Movement flags.
Look like the left tackle. Right now, there will be a silent count.
Three wide receivers. Third down and eight. Brady pedals back. Blitz, throws it, and complete. What's the call? Yep. Oh, what a heavy rush by Duke Pettijohn from his left end.
Out here, the defensive lineman down and goes here. Pettijohn comes around on the inside. The key to this play, Simpkins, takes the right guard and drives him into the turf. Nobody home to pick up Pettijohn. A textbook stunt by the defensive line of Syracuse.
Spotwood back to receive the kick of Sargent. Off his left foot, takes a Michigan bounce. And they'll mark it at the 13-yard line. So you do not want Spotwood with an opportunity to return a punt. Scoreless at the Carrier Dome. 4:50 to go in the first quarter. D. Brown in the Syracuse backfield. Second down, 9. Play action news. He can run. Throws it across the ground. Spotwood. Incomplete. Tough catch. Had to go back behind him on the hip. Nearly pulled it down, but good defense by Michigan.
A little bit of a dangerous throw by Nunes. Anytime someone's rolling to their right, really tough to throw it back to the field. But you saw his arm strength. Little guy. He's gained almost 30 pounds, Nunes has, since he came to Syracuse. Was 159 pounds. He's all the way up to 187. He's got good arm strength, but really dangerous that time. Good coverage by Todd Howard for Michigan.
Syracuse spreads the field, third down and 9, 3 wideouts, and again from the shotgun. Remember what happened last time. Good snap. Henry Ross steps up his Nunes, over the middle, complete. Took a one hopper at the 31, and begging for the pick is Tommy Hendricks, but the officials right on. Right. 43, driven down and into the turf by J.R. Johnson. They love this young kid.
Chris Rippon, who is the new defensive coordinator, was a special team. Had some great ones. Form tackle, kept his head up, started to break down. Watch his feet. As he gets down towards the guy who catches the ball, he starts to spread him out, gets his helmet to the side. It gets no better than that.
And Ed Rippon went on to say, this young guy could be our next impact player. He bakes up Banks at the linebacker spot, and he is a dandy. Michigan back on offense, first and 10 from the 43. Thomas, not much. In fact, he's going to lose a couple.
What great coverage by Syracuse downfield. Again, the alt stays on the sideline. The defense of the Orangemen is going to start to wear out.
Terrell and Walker, two wide outs to the far side. Handoff right up the middle. Nice step. Cuts it outside as Thomas, the 50. This time, Allen went up high, couldn't drag him down. And Anthony Thomas on second effort rumbles down to the 43-yard line.
Aaron Shea, the senior linebacker, 6'5", 250, lined up behind the left tackle. Gets a great job, a great block on number 46, Vernon Banks. Here is the speed and the stiff arm of Anthony Thomas. Gets around Will Allen. When I was playing in the NFL, Craig, we had a running backs coach at Arizona that if you didn't give a stiff arm right there, he fined you $100. Great stiff arm by Anthony Thomas. Gained him an extra 6 yards.
Aaron Shea, the long back. Stumbles incomplete down inside the 10-yard line.
Came up like, hey, I caught it. The official said, yeah, you may have caught it, but you were out of bounds. Really, playing fairly well. We've had great coverage down the field so far.
Second down, 10. Decked. Take
room during the offseason. Both of them say they pushed each other, but Spotwood said there's no question I got outworked by Donald Dinkins.
And the greatest part of that story, they did not know each other that well. Now they're the best of friends. Four wideouts on third down and three. Long ball again. Brady down the sideline. Marquise Walker incomplete. Will Hunter back on coverage. And that's going to force a fourth down.
A little bit of pressure on Tom Brady towards the end of the play. Pettijohn kind of made it move up. He couldn't set his feet. Let that ball fly a little bit, but Walker has a step on Will Hunter. If that ball is delivered on the money, that's six for Michigan.
Spotwood back at the 10. Sargent will punt. And the left footer puts it way up.
That's a great kick, Craig.
Fair catch. Spotwood at the 19-yard line. 26-yard pooch kick and a good hang time, at least nearly 5 seconds. New quarterback, Madee Williams, number 17 for Syracuse. They go the option, Spotwood taken down at the 14.
When we talked to the coaches of Syracuse, they said it was a 2-to-1 system, two series for Nunes, one series for Madee Williams. Madee doesn't quite like that system, doesn't think he can get into enough of a rhythm. Last week against Central Michigan, found a nice rhythm. He's the more option-type quarterback. Already on the first play, he runs the option for no gain. Good tackle by Hendricks. But Madee Williams, when we met him, Craig, very impressive physically.
By Syracuse, minus 12. From the eye, play action, a dark contact, no flags, incomplete, down around the 21-yard line. Todd Howard on the coverage.
The flag goes down in the area of holding. That ball thrown a tad behind the receiver. Todd Howard, who's played a really good game so far for Michigan. Syracuse lost a ton of guys off last year's squad. And if nobody, especially Paul Pasqualoni, will ever forget these three guys, Donovan McNabb, Rob Conrad, the big fullback, and Kevin Johnson. And last year, they accounted for almost all of the offense for Syracuse. All of these guys collecting nice paychecks in the NFL these days, and deservedly so.
Well, McNabb, of course, Philadelphia. Penalty declined. Conrad with Jimmy Johnson of the Dolphins, and Johnson with the Cleveland Browns.
And Jimmy Johnson, a big fan of Rob Conrad, went to Denver last Monday night, put a whooping on the Broncos, and Rob Conrad really doing a nice job blocking out of the backfield. Kind of new for him. Ran the ball a little more here at Syracuse than block.
Three wide receivers on third down. Madee Williams from the shotgun. Comes back three steps. Kentucky on the backs. A little bit late on the decision, and he's taken down at the 16 by Deonte Jones.
A little more accuracy.
Anthony Thomas now 10 carries for 40 yards and a whistle. Well, Tom Brady and Drew Henson have shared quarterback duties, but head coach Lloyd Carr says there is no quarterback controversy at Michigan.
Well, I think we have two great quarterbacks, and what we're going to do is continue to look at this thing and see what best fits our team. I feel extremely confident in both guys. I think they both bring a lot to our team. I think it's a strength of our team. So I spend a lot more time worrying about other things than I do in the quarterback situation.
Good problem to have for Lloyd Carr, but the one thing that can start to happen if you leave Drew Henson for an entire quarter, your true starting quarterback, Tom Brady, get a little stiff standing over there.
Well, Paul Pasqualoni's got the same situation on the other side of the bench. Henson under pressure, throws incomplete. Well, I tell you, Syracuse can really pinch the corners. Pettijohn came in, number 49.
Great way to put it.
Now the kick. Fair catch signaled by Spotwood, and he downs it at the 25-yard line. So Syracuse, in a scoreless battle with Michigan, will have it back on offense. 24-yard kick and no return. We'll take a break. 4:13.
Now, back to your game.
Welcome back to the Carrier Dome. Craig Bowler-Jack along with Ed Cunningham. Scoreless here at the Dome, and Ed, Question is, how surprised are you? Because very, very effective offense of Syracuse, averaging 41 points a game, Michigan at 31.5.
Well, both offenses are sharing mistakes. You got Syracuse going backwards, bad snaps and penalties. Michigan cannot stop on third down the pass rush of Syracuse. So really, it's the offenses that are hurting themselves. But give some credit to defense. Both defensive backfields have played well so far.
Nunes back in at quarterback for Syracuse. Four wide receivers set, goes back, sets up, tucks, and then is buried under a sea of white. Boy, 94, Eric Wilson coming up off the pile.
Once again, it's the defensive line stunt that gets to the quarterback. Earlier, we saw Pettijohn from Syracuse run the loop underneath. That time, it was Michigan on the left side of their defensive line, ran a defensive line stop and got to Nunes. Nunes looked like he was running the quarterback draw, but the defensive end was right in his face when he went to take off.
And we talked about the offense being shut down tonight, but give some credit to the defense because, again, Syracuse in their first two games, they've allowed less than 10 points a game while Michigan has allowed just under 13. Play action, Nunes again, chased, escapes, and then throws downfield. Incomplete at the 40.
Was that number 11 or number 5 at quarterback for Syracuse?
Well, Brominski nearly pulled it down, the tight end, number 87, a big guy at 6'5", but just couldn't quite hang on.
Looking at Nunes, you didn't think he had this kind of athletic ability. You got Josh Williams on the outside. Tommy Hendricks comes from his strong safety spot, and then he throws a ball right on the money. But again, it's Todd Howard. That's three great plays by Howard to knock passes away in this ball game early. A nice game so far by Mr. Howard.
Total yards so far, Michigan on the plus side with 90, and Syracuse still minus 19 yards. Nunes again, the play fake, throws it up, and that one's up to Brown. It's picked. James Whitley. And Michigan with another turnover. That's seven. They're plus seven on the turnover ratio. They have yet to commit a turnover offensively, and now on the defensive side, they get their seventh turnover of the season.
First interception thrown by Nunes so far this year, and just not a good throw. He was looking for Malik Campbell. Overthrew him. Whitley there on coverage. Had help from the safety, so he could cheat it just a little bit. This is over-the-shoulder catch, and Nunes with his first interception on the year. That's a ball that he would like to have back. He just didn't need to throw it. On the season, Michigan plus seven. They are tied for first nationally, and Syracuse giving the ball away. That was a big one by Nunes.
Henson, the quarterback, good protection, runs, throws, fires to the far side. Catches pulled down inside the 30.
What a great job by David Terrell. This is the thing the Michigan offensive coaches were talking about. They needed him to mature on offense before they can allow him to play defense. As Terrell runs his post route and he sees that Henson is in trouble, gets inside of David Byrd, gets the safety, number 29, spun around, running with him, and then he flattens it out. See how he starts going back to the quarterback there? What great heads-up offensive play by David Terrell. You see your quarterback in motion, start working back towards him.
30-yard gain. They pitch it out to Anthony Thomas, and the big fella bulls again past the 25. They'll mark him at the 24. Taken down by Will Allen. I tell you, Terrell is a big play guy. That's his fifth reception over 20 yards this season. And Michigan, after a scoreless first quarter now, beginning to make a move, knocking on that Syracuse door at the 25-yard line.
But again, going back to David Terrell, he's only a second-year sophomore, played as a true freshman. So those are the things as you mature as a Division I football player you have to learn. And that was a spectacular job by him working back towards the quarterback.
Knight and Terrell, the two wideouts. Thomas, the lone back, up the middle. And a touchdown saving tackle around the shoelaces of the 19-yard line by Ian McIntosh.
You ready? Ferris is a great running back. but the defensive lineman just spread the linebackers, go to the outside and get out of the way, because here comes number 32, Anthony Thomas. And if Ian McIntosh doesn't get a piece of his right knee, that'd be another steady six for Michigan.
Thomas now with 69 yards. Syracuse with minus 21. Thomas out by a Michigan. 69. And Henson. Thomas the back. All day to throw. Knight incomplete on the far sideline. Marcus Knight.
Ball any better. The toe was dragged by Marcus Knight when he caught it. A tough call for the official in real time. Obviously, we have slow motion. But what a great throw there by Drew Henson.
Well, the guys in stripes are huddling. Here's McConaughey.
Sideline warning on the offense.
Lloyd Carr and his coaches and players getting up in the officials' faces. The officials want them to back off. I said Drew Henson was accurate because I forgot that, excuse me, Tom Brady, I forgot Drew Henson was in. That was a fantastic throw by Drew Henson.
Ed, I think it's safe to say if this was the National Football League, that would be under review at this particular time.
Well, no, it wouldn't, because you have to have 2 feet in.
True. Thank you. 41-yard field goal attempt by Delverne. Good placement. Kick is up. And from 41, Michigan breaks the drought. Delverne makes it 3-0. We'll come back to the Dome at Syracuse after this.
It's moving a lot quicker than what we just showed you, though, Craig.
Epstein will kick. Michigan by 3, and this will be no return.
This is the biggest game he's played in so far in front of the home crowd. That was wide open. Pat Woodcock was wide open on the play fake. Never got his feet set to throw that ball. He just needs to calm himself down a little bit. The veterans in that huddle, the offensive linemen, Spotwood, D. Brown, they've got to get into his ear and say, just settle. Everything's going to be fine.
From the shotgun. Moon stands, dances, throws it. Patman, the free safety. The second interception of this quarter for the young quarterback, Troy Nunes.
We talked about the veterans. Talked about the veterans on this Syracuse offense. They can't make mistakes like this. The receivers are blanketed down the field, nowhere to go, but right in the middle is Nick Sedano. A good throw by Nunes. It goes through the hands of Sedano, and the problem was it bounced off his forehead, the helmet, straight up into the air, into the hands of Patman. I just talked about the veteran leaders on this team. Sedano's got to come up with that catch.
And now Michigan plus 8 on the turnover ratio this season. Nunes trying to get some encouragement on the sideline. Anthony Thomas, the ball carrier, slices off the right side to the 20, to the 19-yard line. Boy, big gain on first down again of about 8 yards. Harris and Bird made the stop.
Excuse me, this is the first time that I've seen Anthony Thomas live. I've watched him a ton of times on film. The one thing I didn't realize he had, Craig, was the burst. I mean, I knew he was fast. I knew he could get the corner. But that time, there wasn't much of a hole there. Donald Dinkins was closing in. The defense of Syracuse was there, and he burst through that hole. Great burst.
Second down, one pitch. They tried the right side. Now they go left side, and Thomas taken down at the 15. That stops the clock with 9:31 remaining in the half, and Michigan with a 3-0. Marcus Knight in motion. First and 10. Bootleg. Henson throws to the flat. He finds his tight end, Thompson. And he's upended at the 9-yard line. McIntosh made the hit.
You know, when we were talking earlier in the week to Lloyd Carr, he said that this defense of Syracuse is the fastest that they faced, and really talked about their defensive backfield. This looked like it was going to be a much bigger play, but as Thompson turns around, he and McIntosh right there on the scene, goes low against the bigger Thompson. Smart play, but good fill by McIntosh from his safety spot.
Well, in the red zone, Michigan, 15 opportunities, 6 touchdowns, 7 field goals. They missed 1 3-point opportunity. Thomas hits the pile, leans forward. I'd say just on the lean alone, Anthony Thomas is going to give you 1 yard. Greenwood and Bullock teamed up to make the hit.
Bullock having a nice day in the middle so far. He said really this was the beginning of his season. Got to play against Toledo, but he said, I never really got to shake the rust off. Had to sit out last week, which he was not happy about. Understood why he had to sit out. But he said, this is really the start of my season. Syracuse could use a big play out of him right here.
Michigan will line up in the double tight end set on third down and four.
With the athleticism of Henson, a rollout would be pretty good down here.
Marquise Walker is split out to the far side. Henson wants to throw through the hands, incomplete, of Aaron Shea.
That's what I talked about early. Henson's got a very strong arm. Shea is wide open in the flats, and he overthrows his target. And balls tend to get away from guys with really strong arms. He's a third baseman in professional baseball, so you know he's got a strong arm, just too high on his release point, and Shea never had a chance at that one.
Well, Del Vern with another opportunity with a field goal, connected on a 41-yarder just minutes ago to break a long drought.
Great story. This guy got a scholarship last Tuesday before Rice. He is tied for first in the NCAA in field goals.
25-yard attempt. It's up and good. Michigan leads by six. We'll be back. Tailback.
6'2", 205. He's right.
Run the play action. Williams shuffles those feet. Looks. Guns and a big.
One of the fastest players on Syracuse, Paul Pasqualoni, says he's like a jackrabbit in a cornfield. This time he gets by number three, Todd Howard. Ball slightly underthrown, but great concentration. Number 58 is Reynis getting up the middle, but D. Williams has to sidestep him. What a great throw, but an even better catch by Woodcock. Howard had his arm in there. Good coverage. Woodcock, sensational catch.
First down, goal to goal from the 5-yard line. Montgomery shifts up to the slot. Hand off. Dean Brown flags.
Going to get a delay of game on Syracuse. They were in the wishbone. They went to a broken bone. They put the wingman over the right.
Good ball. Delay of the game.
As McConaughey gives us the call.
Yard line. Clock running. Williams wants to throw. Pocket collapses. Got a lane. Throws back to touchdown, Spotwood. Spotwood is back from that season-ending knee injury a year ago, rehabbed mightily, and in his last two ball games, Ed, with now three touchdown receptions.
And a great job of him staying alive in the back of the end zone. He ran the corner route, wasn't there, saw Medea in trouble, came back across the back of the end zone. Heads up play by Spotwood.
Nate Trout, 71 consecutive PATs, make it 72, and he ties Gary Anderson for the school record. 72 in a row as Williams finds Spotwood. 7-3, 7-6, Syracuse.
Right there, but because of the fastball that Drew Henson fired in there, not able to get there in time.
First and 10, Michigan at their own 36-yard line.
Another look, Aaron Shea, the fullback, comes out in the slot.
Four wideouts. Henson again, throwing deep, launches it up. Incomplete. Anthony Thomas, the intended receiver, and right on his back, he was shadowing him, was McIntosh.
Craig, how many times are you got?
That's that one rest that Anthony Thomas gets. Henson pedals back a little bit high on the throw, but again, Terrell has it, loses it. Did he have possession?
The umpire came from behind the linebackers saying he's down, but they are having a discussion. Remember, a split crew here, four Big East, three Big Ten. They're not real familiar with each other.
McConaughey, you see with the white hat, comes in to separate the orange and of Syracuse and Michigan.
And you really just let the officials, if you're McConaughey, you let the guys who think they saw it discuss it. If one has a stronger argument than the other, That one will stand.
And remember, Michigan has yet to turn the ball over this season. Will that change?
But Lloyd Carr said coming into a place like this on AstroTurf against team speed like Syracuse has on defense, he didn't expect that streak to continue.
But Ed, you have to like the fact that the guys huddle up and talk about it. First down, Michigan.
Good throw by Henson down the field. David Terrell having a nice game so far. But again, he tends to jump to catch the ball instead of using his hands. There's no reason for him to jump. Just reach up and catch it. You know what? That's not even a catch. Never had control of the ball. Number three, LaTroy Oliver in there with his hand on there. That was never a catch.
From the shotgun, Henson. First down from the 45. Anthony Thomas lowers its shoulder down to the 40-yard line. And for an update, let's send you back to New York City and Tim Brando. Tim.
All right, Craig, if you were looking for a shootout of the Sunshine State, forget about it. Tennessee's T. Martin, after being out for a down, comes back in, scores on this 7-yard scamper. So the Volunteers have taken the lead in the swamp in the second.
Thought it was going to be an offensive output. Florida not playing great defense so far this year. But T. Martin really very difficult to defend. Florida used to defending against Peyton Manning. T. Martin just so much different, so more athletic running the ball.
Well, 7-6 down south, up north, indoors, may I add. It's 7-6 with Syracuse leading Michigan. Coming up on the AXA Halftime Report, Tim Brando, Spencer Tillman will bring you up to date on all the scores and highlights on a very busy day in college football, and they will put their spin on how they think the season will shape up by the year's end. That's all coming up on the AXA Halftime Report. On Dane.
Couch who?
Yeah. 28 carries, 231 yards. He breaks Archie Griffin's Big Ten record. Tremendous.
And Heupel, the quarterback from Oklahoma, out of nowhere to have a record-setting day.
Flags. Henson spins out of trouble. Breaks a tackle. Comes to the near side and knocked out at the 39. But again, a yellow flag down.
Yeah, it's Duke Pettijohn lined up over the right tackle. Williams trying to get a jump because of the noise and just got a little too much of a jump that time.
Hey, Duke Pettijohn is quick. 4.7 40, and he's strong. Benches about 4.10.
More of an outside linebacker type. Has actually played some linebacker this year, but has that great body lean when he comes off the corner. Just got a little quick jump there.
But Ed, as you know, it's all about timing. These guys are trying to time the snap.
Yeah, but my college coach always told me to be.
First and 10 for the Syracuse 35. Henson stands up in that pocket, throws it to the far side. Tough throw. And a nice catch pulled down by Terrell. That's been the combination here in the second quarter.
Drew Henson really starting to get into a nice groove. Not expected to play tonight, but able because of that contraction.
They want to use his rush abilities. Out of the backfield comes Aaron Shea. And you can hear the cheers in this building. There is a big contingent of Wolverine fans in the upper deck.
And in the corner of the end zone where Aaron Shea just scored is where all the maize and gold and blue are hanging out. Excuse me, maize and gold. But Aaron Shea, a big fullback back at 6'5", 251 pounds. Shows a good burst of speed running by everybody there.
Del Verne with the chip shot and the extra point. Shea takes it in for Michigan, and the Wolverines on the road lead 13-7. We'll be back. Shea with his first touchdown reception of the season. Long kick and no return. Allen takes the knee.
A fullback screen.
Second down, 7 from the eye. 2 wideouts to the near side. Noon's hands up. Johnson, the junior, he backs up Sedano at fullback, and a first down, Syracuse.
Again, though, Craig, it took 30 seconds to get that playoff. You're down to 11 now. just don't understand why. And no sense of urgency to get to the ball as the referees start the clock. And I don't blame these Orange fans for booing.
Well, Shade's touchdown has put Michigan up top. That's the end of the first half with the city. And here's Tim Brando.
Successfully all day, they should be in a situation like this with a minute and 20.
Yeah, there's really going to be some severe questioning of Butch Davis after this one. 27-23, Nittany Lions, a very big road victory for Joe Paterno. Nebraska and Southern Miss. Frank Solich trying to find some answers with his running game severely.
Four on those on the pass from McDee Williams to Pat Woodcock. Time of possession, almost five-minute differential. Syracuse defense has been on the field way too long in this game.
Well, Syracuse won the toss to start this game. They defer, so they'll get the football to start the third quarter. Epstein has it teed up at the 35. And back to receive for Syracuse is Will Allen and Ian McIntosh.
It'll be interesting to see what Syracuse does with their quarterbacks here in the second half. But D. Williams was the more effective quarterback in the first half.
Boy, Epstein with a lively leg and no return. Will Allen takes a knee 5 yards deep, so Syracuse will start at their own 20-yard line. And Ed, here is our Aflac trivia question of the day. You ready? Who is the only man to be inducted into three different halls of fame? Stick around and think about that. We'll give you the answer a little bit later.
And remember, no wagering on the Aflac trivia question.
That's right, no wagering. Well, the quarterback to start the second half for Syracuse is Troy Nunes. Had a couple of picks in the first half of play. And it's going to be interesting for this young guy, Ed, to see how he will respond to pressure. Michigan with the 13-7 lead, and they start Syracuse on the ground. D. Brown to the 21.
So far tonight.
Second down, 9. Pass Woodcock to the 31. First down, Syracuse, and for the first time in a long time, you hear this Carrier Dome crowd respond.
Pat Woodcock getting a lot of playing time. Jeff Lowe, a fifth-year senior, out with a broken foot. Great move to the inside. He got Todd Howard spun around. That's how you release if there's man coverage, press coverage by Howard. Good job by Woodcock. Fake to the outside. Use those hands. A little swim technique inside. Good move by Woodcock.
Nick Sedano checks in number 35 at the fullback spot. Woodcock with two receptions tonight. 65-yard option. Michigan didn't find it. They stay at home. And big number 56 as James Hall wraps up Nunes. Down. Looks like he got the mark. Boy, D. Brown, 6 footer, 206, and Eddie, he hits it hard.
But it is Rob Reines in the middle. The nose guard takes up two blockers so that the linebackers can fill. When we talked to Reines earlier in the week, he's the nose guard in a 3-4. You have to take a pound. He said, I judge my performance on Saturdays by how many guys it takes to block me. That time it took two guys to block Reines so the linebacker could fill. D. Brown, good job fighting up in there because there was really nothing there to get the first down.
So if there is a body that you want to carve to be a nose tackle, it's Reines.
Yeah, 6'1", 290. Yeah.
Great leverage. First down, Syracuse. Nunes on the option. To the 45-yard line of Michigan. Tripped up, and again, we've called his name all night as Todd Howard, the corner, number 3.
This is a double option. A lot of times you hear the triple option.
8 carries for 19 yards. Woodcock comes out from the wide position and sets up in the backfield. First and 10, Orange. Nunes pulls back.
He takes a false step, the speed of Spotwood right by Howard. because of the option, Howard's caught looking into the backfield. As soon as he takes that step and he's flat-footed, Spotwood right by him. Good play by Nunes. Better play by Spotwood.
43-yard gain. Spotwood now four catches for 59 yards. Syracuse, first and goal. They have a double tight end set. Deep ground in motion. Flags. And again, I think... I said I can stop in for a cup of coffee, give the little guy a good night kiss, goes back to the office,
of course,
and usually stays there till after 1 o'clock a.m. Deep round. Past the five and up to the 3-yard line. Tackled by Eric.
Little draw play, got some of that yardage back.
Second down and goal, ninth play of the drive. Michigan trying to shoot the gap. Nunes throws. Typical receiver out of the backfield, only his second catch of the season, but it goes for a big touchdown to put Syracuse on top.
And Nate Trout going for a big record here at Syracuse. If he makes this PAT, he breaks Gary Anderson's record with 73 PATs in a row. I hope I didn't just jinx him.
Nunes is the holder. Will snap, the kick is up.
Oh! Oh, Craig. Looked like somebody from Michigan might have got a hand on it.
Henson gets Syracuse into the end zone, and we'll be back. Trivia question. We're going to give you the answer. Again, who is the only man to be inducted into three different halls of fame?
College, NFL. And lacrosse. Jim Brown, one of the best lacrosse players in the history of the game, two-time All-American. They actually had to change a rule because of Jim Brown. He used to cradle the ball into his chest, plow through everybody and score. You can no longer cradle the ball up against your chest in lacrosse because of Jim Brown.
Drew Henson draws the starting assignment for Michigan to start the third quarter. We're tied at 13 here at the Carrier Dome. And the Wolverines go to their man, the big back, Anthony Thomas, up to the 18-19-yard line. And we talked about offense. Michigan at 31.5 points a game. Syracuse at 41. Expect this close of a ball game?
Well, you and I both talked before the game that the crowd would be a factor, and it has been. Michigan's had a couple of guys jump off sides. The pressure from Syracuse coming from the edges because their tackles slow getting out of their stances.
Second down, seven. Henson throws and we're back here. Collared at the 21-yard line by Will Allen, the left corner.
What a great job by Will Allen that time. Came off of his coverage as soon as he saw the ball swinging out to Thomas. Did a nice job coming off of his responsibility, getting over there, keeping that to a short game. Two guys sending signals in over on the sidelines, trying to confuse the defense a little bit. You never know who is giving the real signal.
And Ed, one of those is the starting quarterback, Tom Brady.
Right now.
Yeah, he's making a mark tonight. Throws, tuck pass to the far side, caught, and the nice lean up to the 35-yard line. That ball was hauled down by Terrell, who's had a very productive night. J.R. Johnson made the hit.
Johnson, we've already seen make some great hits tonight on special teams out there in coverage. But again, Syracuse, one of the things I think Paul Pasqualoni has learned about his team, they can tackle. They lost all of those weapons on offense, but they returned a lot of their defense. And he has some really good young linebackers. J.R. Johnson won. Later in the game, we'll probably see Clifton Smith, a great true freshman.
How about those numbers? 10 of his last 12 for 96 yards and a touchdown. Stands up in that pocket, throws incomplete. Through the hands of his tight end. That was a catchable ball. Thompson, the sophomore from Spotwood, dangerous every time he touches the football. The left footer gets it up, and oh, what a beauty. Good hang time. Spotwood pedals back to the 19. Spotwood pointing for help. Makes a cut, the 25, and to the 32-yard line goes Quentin Spotwood. 45-yard kick and a 13-yard return. Don't go anywhere. 8:28 left, third quarter. Michigan, Syracuse, locked at 13. The sideline, Tom Brady wears number 10, but Lloyd Carvey showing the hand because next week they open up Big Ten play against Wisconsin. And there was so much talk, they had to settle on a quarterback by the time they reach conference play.
And hey, let's not kid ourselves, it's a tight ball game. He's going with somebody he thinks gives him a chance to win.
Hanson, three-step drop, throws it up. One-handed catch! Oh, what a grab by Terrell!
A little shrug of the shoulders, like, what did you expect?
That's like Hanson, though, playing the hot corner at third, making the snag.
You got a sophomore throwing to a sophomore. Michigan fans, you got a few years of fun stuff if you're going to get this. Not a very good throw by Hanson, but what great hands. If you're going to go for the one-handed catch, stop the ball, then get both hands. David Byrd is right there to hit Terrell as he catches. Hey, well, no big deal. I do those all the time in practice.
Well, he's got 4-3 speed. Mr. Terrell, 7 catches, 111 yards. And Michigan on the move, trying to break the 13 all time. Hanson now on the rollout, chase from behind. High steps it out, and then smartly, and may I add, smartly runs it out at the 42.
But there is the athletic ability of Drew Hanson. We've watched the quarterback. He's starting to change my mind tonight.
Play action, all day to throw. Throws it up. Thomas is there. And overthrows by a couple of yards, incomplete. McIntosh on coverage, but Hanson again, it shows you the incredible arm strength he has. And you made a point early in the first half, you know, he plays third base in the minor leagues, and he's got a lively arm, and until he kind of shows or learns how to control the flotation of that football, he's going to be a little bit long at times.
This is his second year in college. He's a sophomore but did not redshirt, played as a true freshman. And Lloyd Carr right now showing us, hey, is this the guy that's going to lead us the rest of the way through the Big Ten schedule?
Walter Cross, the lone back for Michigan on third down and 10. Hanson, good protection, throws it up again. Up high, nobody there. Picked. It's taken in by McIntosh, the strong safety. And the first turnover committed by Michigan this season.
And it's a big one, Craig. A ball, we're just talking about Drew Hanson only being a sophomore, a two-year sophomore, tried to throw this ball away. Marcus Knight.
Kind of odd. Well, this dome comes in mighty handy around mid-November.
No, end of this month it's going to come in mighty handy.
They got chilly last night. I formation. Second down. Nunes again rolls out of that pocket. Stands, looks. Talks, looks. Looks. Breaks the tackle. Needs some help. Down the other way. Oh, my. Throws it down. Everyone is exhausted.
Threw a flag in the end zone for intentional grounding. Now the problem is, Craig, the new rule is loss of down, and the ball is marked where the intentional grounding happened. If he calls this intentional grounding, it could end up being a safety for Michigan. And that is the call.
Safety. Big play.
They changed the rule in college football this year that on an intentional grounding, they try to make it like a sack. So from the point of where the ball is thrown, if it's called intentional grounding, it is now a safety, just like Troy Nunes was sacked. Like I said earlier, is this number 11 or Donovan McNabb, number 5? Michigan running around everywhere. Gold had a chance at him, outruns Hall, goes into the end zone. Now here's where he makes his mistake. Throwing the ball away, nobody in the area. This is not the NFL where once you're out of the pocket, you can throw it out of bounds. It has to be near a receiver. The proper call made by the official and the safety on Syracuse.
Teed up at the 20. Boots it high and long. Thomas at the 19. Thomas breaks a tackle, nearly fumbled, and then taken down at the 40-yard line. And he was hit by Charles Burton.
Okay, we've had Anthony Dirt on the coffin of Florida, but never underestimate Steve Spurrier in a big game. He takes challenges and meets them head on.
Here it's 15-13 Michigan. Second down. Jumps his way past the 30 up to the 33-yard line. James Mungro, only a sophomore. And this young guy, as we mentioned, just a tremendous. You can hear the breath just come right out of this Carrier Dome crowd. Third down. Nunes on the run. Now throws a darting complete. Little hop and a skip. Malik Campbell was in the area. And now a fourth down facing Syracuse. Patman, the free safety, on coverage.
Now, Paul Pasqualoni and his staff, when they go break this film down tomorrow and decide, you know, what happened at the quarterback situation. Nunes, remember, redshirt freshman, a lot of pressure on him to come in. He's done a good job in the pocket, but he just hasn't been very accurate this evening.
Schaefer the kick. Good hang time. Knight waves the fair catch, and Michigan will have it at the 26-yard line. Taking on 18th-ranked Alabama, or Ed, you and I will be. Henson quarterbacking Michigan. Anthony Thomas picking his way. Heading to the sideline, wrapped up. Syracuse, you have to give credit to that front.
And really, a heads-up play by number.
D. Williams, under center, first and 10. The gap was Whitley, the corner, number 5.
Watch as Madee Williams looks like he's going to go to his right, spins out. He's running the option with D. Brown. Looks like there's a lot of room. Cut it up too late. When there's that much room, if there's nobody to force the quarterback, he's got to hug the line of scrimmage. That time, Madee Williams continued in his progression with the running back. But if the defensive end who's supposed to force the pitch is crashed down inside, he's got to hug it, cut it up sooner.
Second down, 6. 4-yard gain. Try the other side. Williams looking to pitch. He touches it. The 50 down the sideline to the 47. Dehani Jones forced him out, but a tremendous run by the quarterback of Syracuse, Madee Williams. First and 10. Syracuse at the Michigan 34-yard line. I formation. Mungrow, again, the ball carrier, stood up, leans, and works his way down to the 30. That was a tough 3 yards. For an update on Tennessee and Florida, let's go to New York and Tim Brando. Tim.
Craig, thanks. Deion Grant had a 34-yard return with an interception of Doug Johnson. That led to Jamal Lewis getting into the end zone, 23-14. Florida's come back. They've driven in for a touchdown. They've had their second touchdown of the night called back. They still have the ball lead.
Down there.
Ball game here at the Carrier Dome, 15-13. Michigan, Syracuse trying to pound the door down. Maybe a yard, man. 2 wide outs to the far side. Williams gets from behind and dropped. Ball on the deck. Fourth down, Syracuse. They mark him.
Steps out, they replace him with Whitley. A great call by the defensive coordinator Herman of Michigan.
52-yard field goal attempt. High snap. Nunes. Thrown back at the 49. You know, Ed, you're going to have to ask Pasqualoni if that was a planned play. It was a high snap, but Nunes took off. You have to wonder what that call was.
No, Craig, that's what's called a fire call. As soon as the snap comes in, 88, Mike Bennett snaps it high. Nunes has to yell, fire, fire. Michigan still up 2.
Third down and 6 for Michigan. 4 wide receivers. Henson out of the pocket, chased and out of bounds. Fourth down. Greenwood tracked him down from behind.
Okay, I've said his name enough tonight. Number 49 is outside the right tackle, Williams. The body lean is what gets it. He drives Henson out of the pocket. He doesn't get the sack, but he flushes him out of the pocket. Morlon Greenwood finishes the play, but it's 49 Duke Pettijohn, who's played a great job, played a great game at that defensive end.
Spotwood back at his own 10-yard line. Schaefer, the left footer, has done a tremendous job with hang time tonight. End over end, Spotwood at the 14, level and thrown back at the 21. 62 so far, Syracuse 70, and in the second half erupted for 113. For a complete college football coverage, make sure you go to cbs.sportsline.com.
Really, the difference has been Syracuse defensively. Everybody wanted to talk about who they lost on offense. They didn't lose a lot of guys on defense. They have a new defensive coordinator, Chris Ripley, and holding this Michigan offense to really 13 points without the safety.
Play fake. It's a quarterback keep. And Henson did a great job down to the 15.
This play really set up because of the blocking on the edge by the Michigan offensive line. Maurice Williams, the tight end over there, is 86 for Michigan. And Maurice Williams did a good job of keeping Dinkins inside so that Henson could get the corner and the first down.
Boy, give Henson some credit. He hit that ball on his off hip and made the big turn and left Syracuse standing back in the dust. First down, Michigan. 4 minutes on the clock, fourth quarter. They're going to pitch it to Anthony Thomas. He cannot get outside and has not been able to all night long. And he took a shot right in the numbers.
Yeah, and there's our man, Keith Bullock. This is a good-looking middle linebacker Syracuse has. Bullock listed at 6'3", 230. When you meet him, he's an imposing.
It's incomplete for the big fella, Evan Coleman. The backup to Aaron Shea at fullback. It was right there in the breadbasket, but came right out.
And that's a shame because Drew Henson had his struggles through the end of the third quarter, beginning of the fourth. That time makes a nice throw to Evan Coleman right in his hands. Coleman unable to convert, and he had the edge. If he catches that and turns the corner, I don't think Syracuse gets it.
Third down.
Comes the people dressed in orange. Unfortunately, the Michigan fans way on the other side of the field. They can't help their team.
51 to go. And any timeouts remaining, you mentioned, as it went to break, they burned two. One remaining for each Michigan and Syracuse. Third down. And another opportunity for Syracuse to stand tall. Henson fires a dart. Incomplete. They have Terrell open around the one-yard line, but it was a bit short, and that brings up fourth down.
Michigan playing it safe. They only had two receivers out in the route, and Shea, the fullback. So Syracuse able to double cover both wide receivers because Michigan very worried about the pass rush of Syracuse. Every third and long before Rice, big kick for him.
Former walk-on had three field goals made last week against Rice. Here's a big one. 31 yards and good. And that pushes the lead to 18-13. But a lot of time left at the Dome at Syracuse. 31 yards. We'll be back. Have a 7 for 82 yards and a touchdown. He's got 3:32 on the clock. Syracuse down by 5. Do the play fake. Sidesteps trouble. Throws. Catch. He's got his man. Campbell, a sophomore from Buffalo.
And what a great story Malik Campbell is. He led her 2 years in a row as a freshman and sophomore as a basketball player at Syracuse, decided to come out for the football team, made his first start last week against Central Michigan. They say this guy has incredible potential, 6'3", 180 pounds, great speed. And Madee Williams, the more athletic of the two quarterbacks, they roll the pocket, gets away from Josh Williams, fires that ball right on the money.
First and 10, Syracuse at the Michigan 33. Williams running, speed, steps out of bounds, stops the clock at the 27, and Dehani Jones, he's got speed, able to chase him out.
He's
got
to learn how to put the brakes on over on the sidelines, tiny sidelines over here at Syracuse.
We talked to Madee Williams a couple of days ago. Look at the guns on this kid. I tell you, he's been in the weight room. He has a great attitude because, again, of the shared time he's had to show with Troy Nunes.
When he came in to our meeting, he had his sleeves right. He's real proud of those arms. He had the sleeves rolled up. Kind of looked like a linebacker when he came walking in.
6'2", 202, runs like the wind, only a sophomore. From the eye. Hand off, deep. Down the sideline and out of bounds at the 15. Tommy Hendricks, the strong safety, got the angle on D. Brown and worked him out of bounds.
Now, when When we talked to George DeLeon, the offensive coordinator, he talked about his offense as a menu. We have a huge menu of plays here at Syracuse, more than anybody in the country. Look at this drive. They've had play action pass. They've had dropbacks. That was a draw play. This is something Paul Pasqualoni requires of his players. Come here. You got to learn a lot of offense.
Longest run of the night by Brown, 13 yards. First and 10, Syracuse. Brown. This time, nothing fancy. Straight up, runs behind Bowen, his center, and Joseph Burton, his right guard.
Now you've got to start thinking clock management. If you're Michigan, you've got to start thinking about stopping the clock. But with only one timeout, very difficult to do that. Syracuse, on the other hand, you want to eat some clock. But, Craig, you just have to get in the end zone. I know you want to eat some clock, but really the only thing that matters right now for Syracuse, get six on the board.
Nick Sedano checks in at the fullback spot, number 35. D. Brown, the tailback. Woodcock in motion, second down and eight. Williams looks. Showing for the end zone, and he throws it out. Smart movement, D. Williams had no place to go. Back there around the area was Spotwood.
And remember, earlier we saw Drew Henson try to throw a ball away to, and Ian McIntosh was able to pick it off because Henson didn't get enough air on it. That time, Williams very wisely out of the back of the end zone. Spotwood over there, but nobody had a chance at that one.
Woodcock is in the slot from the shotgun. Movement up top, and there's flags. I believe it's Banowitz, 59. He took one of those quick, trying to get his edge. Looked like the left foot hitched him a little bit.
And Banowitz went right into the center. Bowen, a little disagreement on what the snap count was. No question.
5 yard penalty from the line of scrimmage.
Breed of left tackle.
Big guy, 6'6", 290, but looks bigger. He's got that big bone structure. But it's interesting, Syracuse players, while they were huddling, trying to get the crowd to quiet down, and there is a nice hush over the crowd right now.
Third down and 13. Madee Williams fires sideline. Campbell spins out of a tackle to the eighth.
We're going to talk about a lively arm. There were a lot of Wolverines in the area of Campbell, and Madee Williams fires that thing in, and Syracuse is going to take their final timeout, and Pasqualoni wants to talk.
Fourth and four, Williams rolls near side. Looking, fires, throws. Woodcock contact in the end zone, incomplete. No flag.
James Whitley got away, got called for holding earlier in the game, and from the angle up here, it looked like he might have got away with it again. Hall applying the pressure. Good job by him making Madee Williams. And it looked like Whitley might have been on the back a little early on that play. Woodcock lined up all the way across the field. Gets a little bit of separation, continuing his pattern. Oh, so close, yet so far. This game far from over, though, Craig. Lloyd Carr knows that. His offense has got to move the ball.
Michigan with the one timeout. Right now, they're just going to sit on it, let the clock run.
I apologize. I forgot that Syracuse was out of timeouts. A big deal. We talked about those timeouts. No, none saved for the end of the fourth quarter.
Fighting in the corner here at the Carrier Dome. 3-0 goes Michigan. And oh, it was a tough battle on the road.
Paul Pasqualoni, very disappointed in the loss. But he's got to be proud about how this young Orangemen team came in here and played. A lot of true freshmen playing for Coach Pasqualoni. Lost a lot of offensive firepower. The offense gelled in the second half, but the defense, man, did they play big tonight.
So Brad Cunningham, this is Craig Bullerjack saying so long from the Carrier Dome. With a final score and a thriller, Michigan over Syracuse. 18-